Over the last year, I've been amazed at the reach of the White Horse Inn. You know, people from over 150 countries download White Horse Inn regularly, read Modern Reformation, download our articles and other resources that we make available. It's really exciting. Only earlier this year, we had a cruise, our first ever, and we met people from all around the world, not only from all across the United States, but from South Africa, from South Korea, the Philippines, and elsewhere. It's really exciting and encouraging to see what God is doing in other parts of the world, and for the White Horse Inn and Modern Reformation to have some small part in that effort. Not only helping people rethink what they believe, but also how we think as Christians. Restoring categories that we seem to have lost. That's what we're all about at White Horse Inn and Modern Reformation. One of the things that we're really excited about is trying to step up and meet some of the needs and requests that we've been receiving from outside of the U.S. So, for example, we will be reaching out to Indonesia. I'll be going to Indonesia this spring, Lord willing, to speak at a number of churches there. There's a growing Reformation movement in Asia in general and in Indonesia in particular. It's a nation of 87% Muslim population, and yet there's a growing and vital Christian witness there. Many Reformation Christians, people rediscovering the relevance of the Reformation, even in a very different context such as their own. Also, Brazil is a place where Modern Reformation and the White Horse Inn have a history. I had the privilege of going down there myself several times and look forward to going down there again. In many ways, our Brazilian brothers and sisters show us what it's like to come to the very brink of disaster between extremes on one side and the other, and to discover the riches of, again, Reformation Christianity that give them ballast and also give them confidence to reach out to a culture that desperately needs to hear something more than superficial presentations of religion and something more faithful than distortions that you usually get from North American sources. And so we have a lot to learn from our brothers and sisters in other parts of the world. We also have a lot that we can do to provide resources that they desperately need and that they're asking for right now. And if this faith is somewhat new in some places, it's very old in others, but dwindling. In Germany, for example, there's an effort to reignite the Reformation there, but the efforts are few and small. I'm planning to go to Germany to help a group of churches there and to celebrate the anniversary of the Heidelberg Catechism. It's very exciting to take advantage of these opportunities, not only to bring a word of encouragement, but also to learn about what God is doing all around the world. This is no longer a movement that is in any way centered in North America. These truths, which came to us from so far away, are now going back around the world, and we're delighted to have a small part in that work. We are thrilled that the Lord has used this organization in the way that He has, Modern Reformation, the White Horse Inn. Over its 20-year history, we really have seen tremendous changes, not only in the lives of individuals, but whole churches. We can't do this without you, and we haven't been able to do it without you up till now. And so we hope, especially if you're someone who has benefited from the White Horse Inn and Modern Reformation, but you've never really supported us in the past, we hope that this will be an opportunity for you to think about passing the word around and helping other Christians know what they believe and why they believe it. With a gift of $100 or more, we'd like to send you an MP3 CD of programs that address one of the big questions that a lot of people ask: is the Reformation over? Now, obviously, we don't think the Reformation is over. Of course, the Reformation is over in terms of a 16th century movement. But the truths that they recovered, we desperately need to recover again in our day. If anything, the church more desperately today needs to hear that great message of grace alone, in Christ alone, through faith alone, on the basis of Scripture alone, and to have our worship and doctrine aimed at glorifying God alone. I know you'll appreciate this CD. For more information, go to our website, whitehorseinn.org/donate2012. That's whitehorseinn.org/donate2012. And thank you for your support of the White Horse Inn.